How's it going, everyone? Today we're going to be doing the Ninja Road that is out on Blazing, and we're going to be doing a two-unit run for it. So if we head on over, I'll show you guys what I'm going to be taking. And it's not too hard of a team. I've already done this, so I know it works, but we're going to be taking both Sage of Six Pass Madaras, the dual Rinnegan Madara, and then just the regular Rinnegan Sage of Six Pass Madara. And the healing from the skill Madara is what really helps you get through this, and also their chakra resets, because I do have them both maxed out now. I ended up getting my skill Madara to his last ability, so I'm all good on that. So this is a team I'm gonna be taking. It's really not that complicated at all, but we're gonna go ahead on this. Also, I mean, if you wanted to, you could take like the Sakura. I could take the Sakura over the Sage of Six Pass Madara, but it just is a lot slower. But she does offer you a lot more health and damage, but also she gives you like 2 times the number of Granny Cat coins. But I'm not really trying to grind it right now. I'm just going to go ahead and do this 2-unit run, and then I'll start grinding. So let's hop up into this. It's really not that hard. Once you get to the end though, I am going to have to start fast forwarding it, because with only 2 units, it does take literally ages to do. Well, not too long, but like I would say at least each map would be like 10 minutes by itself or something like that. So I'm going to definitely speed past it or just cut. But up until then, it's really just simple. I mean, for those of you who have been watching the Ninja Road, you already know which map's going to be a pain. It's going to be Ninja Road. It's going to be the map 7, man. That map is just so annoying. With all those Narutos just popping out, it gets really, really annoying. But I think I found like a little method where I can just kind of like take care of it, no problem. That map actually won't take that long. That might be the one that takes like no time at all compared to the other ones. So we'll see what's up. What's really good about this is I can get my Madara's ultimates and just their regular jutsu up like nothing, man. It's just like clockwork. So on this one, I'm just gonna go ahead and put on the auto. That's really all I can do. There's a lot of points on this Ninja Road where it just takes so long. That's what makes it really annoying. But you really could just like breeze through it. Like I said, once you get to like map 7, 8, 9, and 10, that's where you really gotta start being careful. But it's mostly map 7 and map 9. But I have kind of like a strategy for both of them right here that you guys are gonna see. So it'll be cool to get it done. The Raikage is dealt with. Alright, let's move on to map 3. This should be a boss one. No. Alright, so I just always end up taking this Madara out. And I got a chakra reset, boy. Let's go. Bro, these Madaras with their chakra resets are gonna be like so clutch. It's not even funny. Alright, so we got Shukaku. I'm just gonna go ahead and use my Madara's ultimate. Also, I apologize if I sound weird for y'all. Kind of sick right now, so my voice might be all types of annoying. Alright, boy, there we go. Two Skyline Meteors, and he's down for the count. It's just so easy, man. And then it didn't matter if I got a chakra reset right there, because we're going to move on anyway. We're going to get all our chakra back. This is just another one where it's just really simple to go through. Let's hope I get it. I don't know who I should use. I think I'm going to use the Madara just in case, because, you know, he has the immobilization. But he didn't get the reset. It's really okay though, because they also have the chakra hitback. So if they get hit by normal attacks, their chances of getting it are really high. And just to show you guys, like, I don't have any other teams, so it's literally just 2-unit run. Alright, so in this case, let me try to remember what it was I did. I think I just go up here. Yeah. And I got that chakra reset again, boy. Let's go. But Yugito actually has the heart element, so my Madara is not going to really do that much, but with all these chakra resets, maybe it doesn't actually matter. I think I'm going to just stay close to this one. I kind of already forgot the pattern of the attacks. But as long as I don't get hit by that tail beast bomb, I'm straight. And I'm about to take out both of the arms, so that's not really a problem. But they can get really annoying, like the cat claw and all that stuff. I just have to make sure I don't take too much damage, because I am only 2 units. So if I get hit by 2 simultaneous attacks, like if I would have got hit by the tail beast bomb and that, I would have been down for sure. Let's go, Madara. These resets are just insane, bro. Yeah, one Sage of Six Pass Madara is crazy enough, but like if you put both of them together, I don't even know what to say. Alright, so that should be that. This should just kill right here. We didn't even take out the arms, I guess. They were just tanking those hits. But alright. That's good enough for me. So now we move on to that map. The map that everybody struggles on and hates. But it's really not that big of a deal. I mean, I'm going to show you right here how I do it. Of course, I'm using two Maduras. And I'm getting like my chakra back to back. So that's why. But what I usually tend to do is try to go for this Naruto right here. I'm going to hit him with this. And then I'm just going to stall up chakra while hitting him again. That was just to kind of lower him so it doesn't take so long. But once you start getting more Narutos, you definitely want to stall up on the last one. But y'all see what's going on. And what I think I've noticed also is the more Narutos that spawn in, the easier it gets. Like this first Naruto, he tanks like at least two or three ultimates. But by the time you get down to the last one, they only eat like one ultimate. So you have to be kind of careful about that. And I kind of did mess up here. You're not supposed to get hit by the secret technique. Because it does a lot of damage. But don't worry, I'm gonna show you guys that, you know, you could tank that, but you don't need to. So we're gonna keep going. Knock this boy out already. Come on, man. Alright, perfect. So now we're gonna use this again, and we got the chakra reset. What I tend to do is I'll do that, then I'll use my other Madara as normal jutsu, because I think it does more damage. And just keep trying to take this one out, and then you reset all your chakra again, and then you just attack normally. That's pretty much it. Now I'm just going to reset my chakra for the next map. Alright, so now I can just attack him. I got my chakra back. We're going to move on to the next map. Alright, so the Itachi. Now, this can be very, very, very annoying. Just because of the two units, I'm kind of limited. But what I've seen is it's actually better to keep this Madara out. But once I do so, I'm not going to be able to use my other Madara because you will get switch sealed. So this Madara is going to be out for the longest, but that's okay because he does the most damage because the Yadamir is going to switch over the element to either bravery or also body. And when it does that, it's actually very good because the skill Madara does obviously damage against body, but his ultimate does a lot more against bravery. So that's when you gotta be, so it's kind of like a cycle. You gotta wait over and over again. I mean, we haven't been hit by the secret technique yet, so I can't really show you guys, but you'll see what I'm talking about. Because he's gonna heal up, you're gonna get immobilized, and it's just gonna constantly keep healing as well. So there's no way to dodge this attack, unfortunately. Unless I maybe switched over to the Madara and I would have used his thing. Actually, that probably would have been a smart thing to do. But this method just takes longer. It's really not that big of a deal. I've already gotten a lot of chakra resets, so this isn't going to take nearly as long. And I think he's about to switch over to, okay, body. So that works for me, but I'm still immobilized a little bit. The switch seal is really all that gets you, and then the jutsu sealing as well. But I'm going to try to just take out, because eventually you'll take out the support, and once the support's down, the rest of it really is like no big deal at all. See, there we go. So I could have played that a little better, but it's okay. Because now I am still stuck with the switch seal. I can't switch out because there's no way to dodge this anywhere on the map. And so as a result of that, I can't actually switch over to my Sage of Six Pass Madara, but that's okay. The only problem is when I killed the Yadamira, it actually left him stuck on a skill element, which is probably the least thing I need. That and heart. But it's alright, we're gonna just whittle this down. It really isn't too hard at all. I don't even probably need to fast forward this at all. It's just kind of rinse and repeat. And the thing is, even if the Madara dodges, because, you know, he has that dodge, even if he dodges it, the effects will still be put onto you, which really sucks. So what I could have done was probably switch to the other Madara and just tanked the secret technique every time with my first jutsu, but I don't know. I just wanted to keep doing this because this jutsu does a lot of damage anyway. At this point, I could probably just run in for a regular attack. Yeah. All right, there we go. No big deal. Sorry, Itachi. Kind of got smacked around, my boy. All right, so let's move in on to the next map. And this map. All right, so I got to be careful on this, because his attacks do a lot of damage. So what I tend to do, I'm still switch sealed, so that's not good. But I think I'll be okay, because he's a body unit, so it shouldn't do too much damage to me. But in the future, I want to try to tank all the attacks that he throws at me. But I'll be okay. All right. I'm still switch sealed for one more turn, but as soon as I get done with that, I'm definitely going to pull my boy out, and you guys will see what I'm talking about. Alright, so the secret technique would definitely probably kill me, so I'm just going to keep repeating with my first jutsu on the other Madara, switching back and forth and using ultimates. That's pretty much all you can do. It just takes a long time on this map, but it's really not that big of a deal. Alright, so we're about to finish up this map real quick and finally move on to map 10. Gosh, this map takes the longest, to be honest. But alright, so the next map's probably going to take a little bit too, but it's really not too complicated. It's just a rinse and repeat as well. But mostly I'm just going to be staying up here in the top. First, I'm going to take out the arms. Unlike with the Yugito, I'm actually going to take out the arms this time on the Roshi. And after that, I'll have a guaranteed safe spot. I might take a little bit of damage here, but it's okay. Pretty much, I just gotta keep whittling them down as much as I can. The chakra resets will actually technically guarantee how long this will take, but it's really no big deal at all, especially compared to like the last map. Thank you. All right, so moving forward, I'm just gonna finish off this Roshi boy. I've been rambling long enough. I'm gonna speed up, like I said, a lot of this video, because it's gonna be way too long, but not nearly as long as you would think. And that takes care of the Roshi. And that's pretty much it. That's Ninja Road 23, 2-unit run with the Sage of Six Paths Madaras. I didn't get the objectives because, I don't know, I haven't really gotten into grinding this yet. I'm still gonna grind, probably, for that Darui. Just bring, like, AoE units, and if you have, like, one of the Madaras like I do, just try to, you know, nullify the damage that they do with his first jutsu as well, like, with the secret technique, and you should be okay. But that's gonna be it. Hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you all in the next video.